Hello everyone, welcome back to the NCU Scholarship and Admission online course session. This part we invite Professor Hong Mong-Kai as a representative from the College of Science to give us a brief introduction about the College of Science. Also, we have invite two international students from the India, Reina from Indonesia to share their lives in NCU. And later we will save some time for the Q&A. And if you have any questions, please feel free to leave any questions below. So later we will answer for that. Okay, now, so let us welcome Professor Hong to introduce the College of Science.
Hi everyone, this is John Mengkai Hong, and welcome to the College of Science of National Central University in Taiwan. Okay, I will show you some description of this college. Okay, so I will get started. First, the College of Science consists of 4 departments and 2 graduate institutes, which are Department of Mathematics, Physics, Chemistry, Optics and Photonics, and Graduate Institute of Statistics and Astronomy. First, let's get to the mathematics. Let me show you, that's the building for the mathematics. Okay, so there are 30 faculties and 10 PhD students, and half of them are international students. So we welcome all the international students to apply for our PhD and master program. A master student, we have 64, and undergraduate student, we have 317. Okay, so for the bachelor degree, we have 2 divisions. One is Division of Mathematical Science, which is more theoretical mathematics and some applications. And the second one is the Division of Scientific Computing and Data Science. We just founded 2 years ago, okay? It turned out to be a very popular program. Okay, so for the Division of Mathematical Science, students need to study the fundamental technique of mathematics like algebra, analysis, combinatorics, computational mathematics, differential equation, geometry, probability and statistics. It pretty much covers all field of mathematics. Okay, and for the Division of Scientific Computing and Data Science, it consists of 4 very popular topics. The first one is the scientific computing. The second one is the data science, and or so-called the big data or machine learning. And the third one is the image processing, and we focus on the application of data science to image processing. Okay, and the third one is the financial mathematics. So we also apply the big data, the technique of big data or machine learning to financial mathematics. So it's pretty much all about the data science and its applications. Okay, now we come to the graduate study. For the mathematical degree, we have a pure math group and a applied math group. Okay, for the pure math group, students need to take the basic courses, which are called core courses for mathematics, and it's pretty much like what you have seen before: real analysis, algebra, differential geometry, differential equation, statistics, probability, graph theorem, numerical analysis, and we also offer many advanced courses for mathematics or its applications. And for the applied math group, we have we offer differential equation, numerical analysis, discrete math, probability and statistics, and its related topic to of probability, and also the programming. And since we just found the scientific and data science group, so some of the professors will offer some courses related to the data science. Okay, so here we have many international communication cooperation or the invite speakers, and we also hold many international conference. But in these 2 years, due to the pandemics, so all the conference becomes online. Okay, and we also have the dual degree program with another country. Here, as is shown in the picture, is the student from Indonesia. And we also have exchange program, and a student from France, United States. And that's the picture for the international students. And that's the student from Indonesia. And we also have student from Vietnam, and even the Egypt, okay? And we have very nice math library, and we also have a very nice computer lab. Okay, so I think that's pretty much for the mathematics department. Okay, now next we go to the physics department. We have very, very strong physics department and astronomy program. For physics department, we have undergraduate, master, PhD program, and what we call the Taiwan International Graduate Program. And this program, we also have so many institute which is related to this department. Okay, so we have a very strong group of physics. Okay, so in physics department, there are 36 faculties, 18 professor, 11 associate professor, 4 assistant professor, and 3 project professors. And this, you will see so many research field. For example, some matter, biophysics, high energy, gravitation, astrophysics, plasma, and physics education and condensed matter. Okay, so very, very research field are included. Okay, the research performance of physics department in the past 5 years, there are totally 1,535 papers published in SCI. Okay, so it will be like 300 papers per year. Okay, so that's pretty strong. Okay, and the grant they got for the past 5 years are 458 million of the NTD as New Taiwan dollar. Okay, that's the grant we got from the government. Okay. Okay, and we also have many large scale project. It means huge project like So the government spent lots of money on it. So you will see all the equipments. Okay, very important equipments. Okay, and for the undergraduate program, okay, there are two tracks. For the first 2 years, they are pretty much the same. Okay, but when you get to the junior, you will see there are two tracks. One is you just take the courses and you can graduate. And the other one, you take some courses and then you do some special topics and you write the thesis and you also have the oral exam. Okay, so it's pretty solid. And these are all the courses they offer. Okay, you just look at the English part, but it's good to learn some Chinese character of, okay? Okay, so that's a very special one, annual meeting. In each year, they have the, what we call the annual meeting for students. So students just do the project and then present their achievement and communicate it with other students. Okay, so they did it every year. And so you will see MOSD means the grant from the government. Okay, so the undergraduate research project, you will see NCU is ranked number one in Taiwan. Okay, it's a lot better than National Taiwan University. Okay, so that's for the past 5 years. And for the best dissertation award, we will see that we are ranked number two, okay? Just behind NTU a little bit, okay? So we really have pretty very, very strong physics program. Okay, and we also have scholarship granted by the Department of Physics, and there are several scholarships. But for the detail, I encourage you to write an email, contact the department about the detail. And here, due to the time, I can only show you the slide. Okay, so then let's get to the Department of Chemistry. Okay, so the Department of Chemistry are founded in, graduate program are founded in 1993, and graduate program are founded, undergraduate was founded in 1995. It seems like a pretty new program, but we have a very, very strong chemistry program in Taiwan, okay? And we have faculty members, 16 faculty members, 14 professors, so each of them are well established, okay? And we have two very young assistant professors and five adjunct faculty member and three teaching assistant. And all the academic program cover four traditional disciplines: organic, inorganic, physical, and analytical chemistry. Okay, and research can be generalized into two interdisciplinary area, which are material and environmental analytic chemistry. Okay, and in the recent year, they also developed the biochemistry, will be the next area to develop. Okay, so these are the details of the faculty member, or you can check on the website. Okay, and student, we have 159 undergrad and 156 graduate master student and 13 doctors PhD student. Okay, and these are the courses they offer. You can check on the website. And here comes the government spend a bunch of money on the lab. Okay, so they have a very nice equipment in the lab. Okay, so you will see all kinds of expensive equipment. It costs million dollars. Okay. Okay, so the development of policy in the future for the chemistry department, okay, is providing an excellent learning atmosphere and environment. All students train with a strong chemistry background, both in theory and application. All students to be excellent, outstanding chemistry. Okay, an academic research goal is continuously growing and developing, and recognize the best department nationwide or worldwide in certain field. Okay, and now they are on the way to achieve their goal. So the Department of Optics and Photonics, okay, they have it was established in 1982. Okay, and the faculty and staff, they have 22 full-time faculties, and students, they have many graduate students. Okay, so because the need of the country, okay? The country need many graduate students. So it is a very popular industry. So they create 270 graduate students, include MS and PhD program, okay? And 180 undergrad students. So you will see the amount of the graduate student is bigger than the one of undergrad, okay? So it turned out it's a very, very popular industry. So, okay, so now they has a award like 1,700 master student and 200 PhD student. Okay, and these are their research field. You can see many of the field are studied. Okay, so you can check the website. I will now go through the detail. And recently, they developed the technique of quantum computing, which turned out to be that's the important technique of quantum computer. Okay, so you will see all the facilities. Okay, and for the scholarship, okay, so for the international graduate, for the international graduate program, you can check on the website, okay? And okay, so here what we are talking about is what is the financial support, okay? So each one of you, when you get in, you are guaranteed, okay? If you get into this program, you are guaranteed to have the financial support, so you don't have to worry about your living quality in Taiwan. Okay, you just concentrate on your study. Okay, so for the master's degree student, they offer you at least $335. So it will be like 10,000. Taiwan dollar, okay? And for the PhD student, they offer $500. So it will be like 15,000 per month, okay? Okay, so that should be enough for your living expense. Okay, and they also mentioned the on-campus housing is $3,000. I think that's too much, right? Maybe later Reina can talk about how much for the on-campus housing. I think it's like half of them is like $1,500 per year. Okay, and off-campus is like maybe $3,000 per year. Okay, so so I think $335 or $500 per month, that should be enough for your living expense. Okay, now let's get to the Graduate Institute of Statistics. So they only offer the program for master degree and PhD degree. Okay, so for the Graduate Institute of Statistics, it was founded in 1979, and PhD program was founded in 1987. Okay, so they recently focus on the financial engineering industry. Okay, and the academic research and talent development. Okay, so okay, so in respect to the teaching, okay, we have been dedicated to related statistics theory and the application of software and hardware, okay, with the expectation that students can be applied. And for the academic research, the department, in order to develop the intensive and deep soil research, the institute not only cooperate with the Department of Finance and the Biomedicine, but also integrate with the Research Medical Institute. Okay? Okay, so in order to attract outstanding students and enable them to actively devoted themselves to research, the institute also provides scholarship. Okay, so basically they provide scholarship, but I have to say what we mean the scholarship is the financial support. Okay, you don't have to worry about the living expense in Taiwan. Okay. Okay, meanwhile, we encourage students to participate both the domestic and overseas seminars. Okay. And there are 7 faculty, and these are their research field. Okay, so finally, we get to the Graduate Institute of Astronomy. And this one is, I have to say, it's we have a very, very strong program in astronomy in NCU, okay? Then it was founded in 1992, okay. Okay, and the courses they offer are including stellar structure, atmosphere, stellar formation, evolution, galactic astrophysics, large scale structure, and cosmology. Okay, and observational astronomy, theoretical astrophysics. Okay, so for the detail, you can check on the website. Okay, the important thing is their faculty participate in international astronomical project such as this important project. Okay, and the institute run its own ruling observatory. Later I will answer some question about the ruling. So this one seems like a very attractive goal for for you guys to go for this program. Okay, so we have a master's student, we have a local student, 24, foreign student, we have 4, and PhD student, like local student, we have 6, and foreign student, we have 6. Okay, and that's the brochure of the Graduate Institute of Astronomy. Okay, and please check out the website. Okay, so I think I will stop here. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you, Professor Hong, for the detailed information about programs of the College of Science. Now next, let's welcome our students, Reina from Indonesia, to share her life in Taiwan and also in NCU with you guys.
Hi everyone, my name is Reina. I'm a PhD student over here and I'm from Mathematics Department. And currently I will share to you about my life in NCU and especially in my department, Mathematics Department. The staffs, they are really nice, the professor really care about you, they are really encouraging you to study more. And then a few semesters ago, I faced some difficulties. I faced this problem that I really need to take this class. The class is finite element method, but somehow the class is not over in the system. So after I talked it with my professor, and I think my professor talked it with another professor and with some staffs in my department, and they give me some solutions, which is they're going to over the class in the next semester, which really helped me a lot because I really need to take the class to graduate from my program. And then the life in Taiwan, it's really nice also. The price of the food is cheaper, a little bit cheap. And the people are helpful again. They are really helpful and they're really friendly. If you're afraid about the cost, don't be worried. I think if you live on and off campus, the price will be different, of course. The price on campus, I think my estimation, it will be around $1,000 USD per year. And if you live off campus, it will be It will depend on the place that you live in, but in my experience, it's around 2,000 USD per year. So, and then, oh, again, and I forgot to mention that a lot of classes are offered in English, which is really, really helpful for me to learn. So that's pretty much it.
Okay, thank you, Reina. Yeah. Next, let's welcome Alu from India.
Hi, hello. I am Anumali Velaswamy. I am from India and I am a PhD student in Department of Chemistry and my professor is Dr. Ming Chao Cheng. I have joined in the NCU in September 2018 and this is my fourth year in NCU. First of all, I would like to say about my department. My department offers so many courses which is partially in English and some of them are Chinese. So in the first time, I was afraid how I'm going to learn the Chinese courses, which were most of the Chinese Taiwanese students are present, and very few of them are international students. But later, each professors make sure that we international students understand all the classes by teaching in English and Chinese. And some of the professors take some special time to make sure and teach international students that all the contents are understandable and we are clear about the subjects. So that I was able to pass all the subjects with good scores. And later on, I would like to say about the department faculties. Whenever I approach the department for any kind of doubts or clarification, they guide me throughout the process and they make sure that I understand and I clear all my doubts. Later on, the most important and backbone for supporting system for my career and then my research work is my lab and my advisor. The lab mates are so friendly and they teach me and throughout my beginning of my PhD, they taught me everything, each and every learning, and I learn and experience so many things which facilities available in my lab and my department. So far, my lab and my professor support me even financially, and I have fully funded scholarship, which is very helpful for all the international students. Also, they are supporting even OIA and department and professor. They are supporting with extra scholarship, which is very helpful for your living in Taiwan. And my department encouraged me to attend the conference and the which is international or national. And I attend so many conferences in the last 3 years, and I got some awards, which will be helpful in my future career. Best dissertation award, and I got in the last year from Taiwan. Also, I was able to publish good impact factor journal. So soon I will graduate with good publications from my lab and department. So I'm so thankful for the opportunity for the department to take a career in this NCU. And I welcome you all international students to join the Department of Chemistry and explore the research facilities available in NCU. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. So now we're going to get into the QA part. We have select several questions about the College of Science. So the first question is, are all the programs in College of Science lecture in English? If not, please tell us what programs can be offered to the international students if the students never learned Chinese before.
Okay, so about this question, I will give the answer as follows. Okay, not all the lectures, not all the class lecture in English. Okay, but some program, for example, the program in astronomy is our lecture in English. So if you want to apply it, then there shouldn't be no problem. Okay. For some programs, if they know there are some foreign students in that class. Okay. So if you are going to take that course and you tell the professor, you say, you need to take that course, then the professor will switch to the English lecture. Okay, so you really don't need to worry about that. Okay, so all you have to mean is you have to understand English. Okay.
Okay. Okay. So yeah. The next
question. Well, we don't offer it in Japanese. Sorry.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. The next question is about the language proficiency. What is the language of this should be the English requirements of each program? And then we also have the students have the questions about my language certificate is already expired, but I cannot take the exam because of the COVID-19. So can I upload the expired one? So and we also have another questions about that all courses in my previous degrees are actually lecturing English. Can I upload the statement later issued by my previous university stating that the medium instruction is English or all the courses I took are lecturing in English as a language proof?
Okay, so like what I say, you don't really have to worry about that, right? Especially during the pandemic. Okay, so the requirement for English in each program are different. Okay, so I really encourage you to check with the brochure, the website of the announcement of each program. You can contact the department. Okay, and due to the pandemic, the college accept the expired English certificate. Okay, so don't worry about that. And also, only some programs require English certificate, some other don't. So you just have to check with the department that you are going to apply to see they really need the certificate or not. Okay? I'm not sure the math department, do they need a certificate?
it's okay. So the students need to contact the programs
right.
to ask about the language requirements.
Yeah. Yeah.
So the next question will be: must I contact the NCU professor first, to find an NCU professor who is willing to be my advisor before applying for the NCU's admission and scholarship?
Okay. about this problem, I strongly suggest that you do that. Okay, contact the professor you are going to work for. Okay, because it might relate to your financial support or your scholarship. Okay, so you need to talk to them, and if the professor like you, then they are going to we all have the grant, so it's easy for you to get your financial support. Okay,
so it's really important for you to attach the professors before you're applying for the NCU, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so the next question will be average. How long does it take to obtain a master's degree or a PhD degree?
I would say each different, it's different, but it's in average, like it takes 2 years for a master's degree and 4 to 5 years for a PhD degree. That's the average.
Okay.
Yeah.
Since the time is limited, so this will be our last question. What is the amount of the scholarship I might get as the master or PhD student?
Okay, like what I said before, first we have to define what is scholarship, or what you need is just the financial support. Okay, so I want to say one more time, okay? The College of Science guarantee each international student they will get their financial support during their study. Okay, so you really don't need to worry about the living expense here. Okay, so about the financial support, we offer including and the college will offer around 10,000 NTD, New Taiwan dollar for master student, and twelve thousand for PhD students.
Okay.
But for some students, they even get more. So for example, Reina. Actually, Reina is my PhD student, and he got the financial support from the department. Okay, that's around
nine.
Do you mind I say that?
Yeah.
It's 9,000. Okay, and I also give him the financial support like a lot. So I'm not going to say how many, okay? But it should be enough for her to do the shopping every week, okay?
So as you are the, if you apply for the College of Science, so you can do the shopping every week because you get enough financial support.
But basically, at least for a master's student, you will get 10,000. And PhD, you will get around 12,000.
Okay.
It's not even include the
support from us.
Yeah.
From the support from the I office.
Yeah.
Okay. So thank you for standing with us until now. This is the end of the session of the College of Science. So next coming up is the information from the College of Engineering. So stay tuned for more information about NCU. See you soon. Bye bye.
Bye bye.